Hello, my name is Grayson Ogle, and I would like to present to you the artist Jacob Lawrence. Jacob Armstead Lawrence was born in Atlantic City, New Jersey in 1917. After moving around the Northeast due to a divorce and lack of work caused by the Great Depression, his mother and sister made their final move to Harlem, New York at the age of 13. Lawrence was enrolled in a public school and an after-school art program at Utopia's Children's Center. Here he developed his passion for art under the mentorship of Charles Elston, who was noted to be impressed by Lawrence's early art skills. Lawrence was forced to drop out of high school in his senior year due to his mom losing her job, and then enrolled in the New Deal's program, Civilian Conservation Corps. When he returned to Harlem, he was quick to advance his passion for art and become acquaintances with sculptor Augusta Savage and Professor Surfeit, who urged him to immerse himself in the arts of African and African-American culture. While still struggling financially, Lawrence was able to make art for the Works Progress Administration, where he painted many series, including that of The Life of Toussaint L'Ouverture in 1937, pictured on the left, The Life of Frederick Douglass in 1938, pictured on the right, and The Life of Harriet Tubman in 1939, pictured in the center. During these years, he also obtained a scholarship to the American Art School in New York and was the recipient of the Rosenwald Grant, a fund for African-American artists for 3 consecutive years. After a lengthy art career, Lawrence passed away while in 2000 in Seattle. Being a black male and in a poor economic position until his 20s, Lawrence became a qualified artist to illustrate the injustices African-Americans are facing. He additionally was thrown straight into African-American culture and art growing up, being taught by mostly black artists and mentors such as Charles Elston, Augusta Savage, and Professor Surfeit. He continued to develop his artistic style throughout the Civil Rights Movement and was a powerful influence for him to embody the social progress efforts. David Driskell, an artist and scholar in the field of African-American art, was quoted saying that Lawrence never embraced the Black Power movement as a black-only topic. He instead attempted to embrace a full and colorless humanity. Lawrence's art mostly used the colors black and brown for the figures in his paintings, but instilled the characters with universal longings and desires independent of skin tone. When he was only 23 years of age, Lawrence created his best-known series, the Migration Series, which was supported financially by the Rosenwald Foundation. In this series, he details the events leading southern black communities to migrate north in search of better work, housing, and social climate. The series as a whole is thoroughly and expectedly depressing, but hopeful of life in the North and determined for better living conditions. Lawrence retains personal ties to the migration of blacks to the North, being born during his parents' northward trek from Virginia and South Carolina, and growing up moving from New Jersey to Pennsylvania and finally Harlem, New York. Lawrence employs carefully thought-out composition to evoke many emotions in the viewer. In the painting on the left, the mother and child are placed in the middle of the room and made relatively small compared to the vast and open space that surrounds them. The wall's color choice of teal causes the wall to appear even larger and airier when contrasted with the brown and dark floor below them. In this way, the piece shows the feelings of weakness felt by African Americans during the migration and the poor economic status that they experienced. The painting of the right places people waiting for northbound trains in horizontal geometric lines with their heads facing the top of the scene to symbolize their organized movement northward. In both of these paintings, Lawrence promotes the feelings of community and the struggling African Americans. In the left, the child's eyes creates an implied line towards the mother, connecting the two emotionally. In the right, the clumping of people waiting, along with the two conversating people in the foreground, connects the families migrating. Additionally, the use of multiple colors for the people's clothing serves to show that not all people had the same background, but still came together in this era. In both these paintings, Lawrence retains directionality in 2 separate ways. On the right, he does this simply by showing the people migrating from the south to north and east. On the left, he does it abstractly by showing the people migrating in the direction of the birds, who are known to migrate north in search of better conditions. Additionally, he uses yellow highlights on the front side of some of the migrants in the left image to symbolize the brighter conditions in the north. In other paintings, he uses bright, vibrant, and Americana colors to show how happy a mixed American society could be. Thanks for listening to my presentation on Jacob Lawrence.